Even if you're just starting out on the harp and think it's mostly something you're doing for yourself, it may happen sooner than you think that you'll start playing for others too. For a lot of us, the first few performances can be a challenging experience. While we definitely can learn a lot from that, I believe that when it comes to making mistakes, it's always better to learn from others rather than having to make your own. My name is Zuzanna, I'm a harpist and a harp teacher, and today I'm going to share with you 7 mistakes that you want to avoid when getting ready to play for others for the first time. It all starts all the way back when you're choosing your pieces. Now, if you're watching this video the night before your performance, ignore this point for now and move right to number 2, but maybe have a think about it in the future. You want to feel really comfortable with the pieces that you're going to play. So if it's the first time that you're playing for others and it makes you a little bit nervous, perhaps instead of playing the latest piece that you've learned, you may want to consider playing something you played a while ago. It may be below your current level, but the truth is, unless you're playing to a group of harpists, people often cannot tell how advanced a piece of music is on the harp. And you will feel much more comfortable playing something you consider easy, rather than thinking that this piece is hard, or maybe even too hard as you're preparing to perform. Sometimes we think we play our chosen piece from music, but because we have practiced it a lot, we've actually happened to memorize large sections. It can then happen that once we arrive at a section that we play from memory, we will play it through, but then suddenly the notes stop coming into our head and fingers, and when we look back at the page, we have no idea where we are. This is because when we practice, we usually practice in smaller chunks, and we normally stop to look and check things in the music. This makes it harder to tell where exactly the limits of our memory are. So, when you're getting ready to perform, you need to be very clear whether you're going to play from memory or with music. And if you realize you're switching to playing from memory in some beats, but not for the others, try to be very clear where and when you need to come back to the page. You may want to record yourself so you can observe how you're moving your gaze from the harp to the music and when that happens. This will also help you with the point number 3, which is performance practice. You've practiced your pieces, but have you practiced performing? As you're getting ready to play for others, you need to start practicing playing the pieces through and also getting used to being watched while doing this, in one form or another. You can start from recording yourself, then you could possibly make another video that you will share with your friends, for example, and then you could play the piece to someone over a video call. In the process, also try to ask people to listen to you in person. Even if you think that your family hears you every time you practice, it will actually feel very different when they sit down in front of you and give you their whole undivided attention to listen, so make sure you don't miss out on that opportunity. When we practice, the harp usually stays at the same spot, and the sound that you make and what you see through the strings will usually sound very similar from one day to another. But even if you're going to play for someone from your own home, you may still need to shift the harp a little bit for them to see you better or for the harp to be seen on the camera. This may change how you feel while you play, and it will be even more different if you play at a whole different venue. So make sure to mix things up from time to time when you practice. Setting the harp up at a different angle or moving to another room will all be very helpful. And if you're going to play somewhere else, try to arrive early and play a few notes to check how it sounds, what can you see when looking through the strings, and how that feels. Also check there's no red carpet in the background. As you play more and more, you will get used to playing almost anywhere, but the red carpet can make it tricky. In the few days leading up to your first performance, you may feel like you've got so much to practice that you're way too busy to tune your harp. But it's important to keep your instrument in tune, especially when playing for others. Even if you're moving the harp around and by definition you will be tuning it again just before you play, the instruments that are tuned regularly tend to stay in tune better. Also, I don't know about you, but when I'm slightly nervous, I sometimes find even the most basic things suddenly a lot harder to do, and with tuning it's as if my ears are shutting off when I'm stressed. So, do yourself a favor and make sure you're tuning your harp regularly in the days and weeks before playing for others, and then on the day it will be easy to just do some final adjustments. Take the time you need before you start. And I'm not only talking about being ready on time or arriving early at a venue, but about that moment when you sit down at the harp to play, just before you start. When we're nervous, time seems to be running faster, and sometimes it feels like we have to start right there at this very minute, otherwise we're somehow wasting our listeners' time, which, by the way, is absolutely not true. I can assure you, even if you feel that you're taking ages, it's very unlikely your audience will think that. If anything, waiting for you to start will help them to focus on your performance and start really paying attention. So take as much time as you need to settle, to breathe, to remind yourself what you're going to think about as you prepare to play these first notes. Before you start, check your levers or pedals if you play a lever or pedal harp. It can be very off-putting if you start and only then realize something is seriously off. So if you're playing with music, I would add a big colorful note at the top of your score, and if you're playing from memory, make an equally big colorful mental note to check on your setup while you're taking the time to play. Have you already played for others? What other advice would you offer to someone who's about to do it for the first time? Let us know in the comments. I will be looking forward to hearing from you and to seeing you here very soon for another episode of the Coffee Break Harp. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on future episodes and take care in the meantime. See you soon. Bye!